How many times, oh God, forgive me? Have I gone too far and sinned too much? Am I too bad to be saved? Can I be saved if I keep on sinning? It might be surprising to hear the answer is both yes and no. Let's work it out. In another episode, I explained that sin is any transgression against God and His law. Sin is lawlessness, for which there will be judgment and a penalty to be paid. So, yes, the reality is that you have done too much to be forgiven by God. James 2 and 10 says, "For whoever keeps the entire law and yet stumbles at one point is guilty of breaking it all." So, telling a lie, cheating on your spouse, or even stealing post-it notes from your job is all sin, and every sin is offensive to God. There's no little sin, just as you can't cheat on your taxes a little bit. Romans 3:23 tells us, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." However, if we keep on reading, it goes on to say that they are justified freely by His grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. So while we have offended God with our sin, we also know that God loves His children. John 3:16 should come to mind because it says, "For God loved the world in this way, He gave His one and only Son, so that everyone who believes in Him would not perish, but have eternal life." The other side of the coin is not about what we've done, but what Christ has done for us. So we can't use up God's grace and forgiveness. Jesus paid it all for those who would follow Him. Check out what the psalmist says. "For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is His faithful love toward those who fear Him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has He removed our transgressions from us." The devil, who is the author of lies, wants us to think that our sins are not forgiven, even though Scripture tells us differently. Because of the finished work of Jesus on the cross, our sin debt is paid. Satan wants to continue to remind us of our past transgressions, and he makes it hard for us to accept God's promises. Psalm 103 not only tells us of God's forgiveness, but he also removes our transgressions as far as the east is from the west. He's not like us, where we will forgive but not forget. God doesn't hold grudges. When we come to Him in repentance and we ask for forgiveness, God will forgive. 1 John 1, 8-9 says, "If we say that we have no sin, we are deceiving ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, He's faithful and righteous to forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness." While we can be sure that God will forgive us, it's not a license to sin. Paul says it this way, "What should we say then? Should we continue in sin so that grace may multiply? Absolutely not. How can we who died to sin still live in it?" For instance, your spouse being forgiving doesn't give you a license to commit adultery. Christians are not perfect, so we will stumble and fall, but we should not have a lifestyle of continual sin. So, brothers and sisters, while we continue to deal with the ups and downs that we have in our lives, we need to remember that God's forgiveness is like a bottomless well or a perpetual fountain spring. Ephesians 1 tells us that God loved us, He forgave us, and chose us to be in Christ before the foundation of the world. So well before you did any of the crazy stuff that you did in your life, God had already chosen to love you and forgive you when you came to Him. The blood of Jesus and the grace of God is far greater than any of our sin. However, having said all that, there actually is one sin that Jesus Himself says is unforgivable. If you'd like to know what that is, leave me a comment down below, bless the like button, and subscribe to the channel. I'll address this next time, but until then, I hope that this information will help you be strong and courageous in living out your faith today.